Good afternoon, sir. We are from CCB, third year computer science students. We have a presentation on DFA state minimization. Our group members are Ritesh Singh, myself Syed Arif Imam, and Rahul Raj. So let's start with the topic. Our topic is the minimization of data methods. So here comes two theorems mainly. There is a one is equivalence theorem and second one is Myhill-Neurath theorem. So we don't have to go into that. We just have to understand using equivalence theorem. First of all, the step one, we have to eliminate all dead states and inaccessible states in the given DFA. Means dead state means all those non-final states which transits to itself from all input symbols, and then inaccessible states. Inaccessible states refers to those states which can never be reached from initial states. So these are called inaccessible states. Second step two, we have to make a transition table of the given DFA. We have to make a column and then present input and output 0, 1, and we have to start in step 3. We have to start applying equivalence theorem, and we have to take counter variable and we have to initialize it with 0 and all, and we have to divide sets into two sets such that one set contains all non-final states and other sets, and then we will do partition P0. In step 4, we will do the k increment by 1, and we have to find pk by patterning the different states of pk minus 1. So in step 4 itself, the next step will be in each set of pk minus 1, we have to consider all possible pair of states between each set that the two sets should be distinguishable, should not belong to same set, and we have to repeat this same step, repeat the above four steps until we get the upper state. We get one state equal to another state, means the sets start keep repeating, and in at last step we will. When all sets belong to equivalent, then we will form a DFA diagram, and we will minimize it using DFA. And at last, one thing: the number of states in minimal DFA is number of sets in PK. So here comes the first problem. In first problem, we have to, in a diagram is given, we have to tell the number of states in the minimization of DFA. So first we will draw a table where we will list all in some initial states, final states, and then we will see whether input A and B. So we will just go through it where for B input, where does Q0 goes to Q1, and for A input, Q0 goes to Q3, and like this we will all list it in the table. Then we will check and then we will find zero equivalence. Zero equivalence means we will have to list non-final states and final states together, and then we will check. First, as it is mentioned in the diagram, that Q4 is the final state and Q0 is the initial state. So we will just go through it and taking that Q0, we will check it part by part, like from Q0 parsing with Q1. Then we will check whether they goes to the same state. For A and B input, they go to the same state, then we will put them into the same set, otherwise they will be with the put it into the other another state. So first we will check for Q0 and Q1. Then for Q0 and Q1, Q0 goes to Q3 for A input, and Q2 and Q1 goes to Q4. So they both belong to different set, as Q3 is initial state and Q4 are different. Q4 belongs to different set. So we will, and for Q0 B input, Q0 goes to Q1, and Q1 for B input goes to Q2, and we will check that all goes to the same digit or not. Then they all goes to the same set, and then we will put them into the together set. So we will just do it for Q0 and Q2, and same for Q0 and Q3. Then we will do it like this, and we will get the zero equivalence, that we will have Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3 in the same set, and it means non-final set, and Q4 in the final set. And after that we will check one equivalence. One equivalence, we will, above step we have repeated, then we will repeat that same step, and in one equivalence we will get that Q0 belongs to another set, and Q1, Q2, Q3 belongs to another set, and Q3 will belong to another set. So Q1 will be separately, and Q1, Q2, Q3 will be together in a separate set, and Q4 will be in a separate set. And we will repeat this, and then we will go to the next step. The next step is Q2 equivalence. For Q equivalence, we will repeat the above step once more. And by repeating the above step, we will get that the same states, same process has been repeated, and it will be that same. We have got the same states here also, like the above one, that Q1 is separated, and Q0 is separated. Sorry, Q1, Q2, and Q3 are in the same set, and Q4 are in the separate set. So we have got to the final set, and after that, we will just draw the final DFA diagram. So final DFA diagram will be like that. Q0 will be separate, and Q1, Q2 will be separate, and Q4 will be separate. Like Q4 is the final set. So we will draw the DFA diagram, and as it is mentioned in the presentation in front of you, and there will be three states. So the answer of this question, that the number of states in resolution of DFA is 3. So the answer is 3. So the next problem will be presented by our group member Rahul Raj. Rahul, please present.
Good evening, sir. I am Rahul Raj. Sir, I will be presenting question 2. Sir, in DFA, our topic is DFA minimization. So in DFA, there is only one path for a specific input. And what we do in state minimization is that DFA minimization is the task to transfer a given deterministic finite automation into equivalent DFA. What we did here in question number 2, as Arif explained, first we remove all the dead state, that is if that from particular state there is no only outgoing edges, then and no incoming edges, then it will be dead state. And after that we find the zero equivalent state. What we did in is that we make two states. One set consists of final states, and other set consists of non-final the states that are not final states. After that, we find the first equivalence. We try to differentiate between all the states, that whether they fall in the same group or not. if they fall in the same group, the those states which fall in the same group, we make sets different sets of that. And those which do not fall in the same group, we make another set. Like this, we continue until the two equivalent states, until the two consecutive rows become give the same result. And sir, after making like you are making the transition table, Arif, next slide. Arif, next.
Yeah.
Next slide.
Done.
Here we make the transition table. Here we make the transition table, and after making all the equivalence states, the final state, final, our DFA will be like this. And in question number 4, sir, we did all the steps like one. We also did the same process. And what?
Rahul, wait a minute. Let me present 3, then you will go to 4. Okay, na?
Okay.
Okay, as you presented question number 2, so I will present question number 3. The question number 3 is definition of language L with alphabet A is given as following: bracket close NK L A K O K 0 and N is a positive integer constant visible, and what is the minimum number of states needed in a DFA to recognize L? So here the thing is, we have to require the minimum number of states that we needed to in DFA to recognize L. As that we have to note here that we have to imagine, let N is equal to 3 and K is equal to 1, therefore N plus 1 states. We have to note that N is a constant and K is a positive integer. For example, if N is given as 3, then the DFA must be able to accept 3A, 6A, 9A and 12A. So to build such DFA, we need 4 states. So the answer to this problem will be B, N plus 1. Now move to the next question. Rahul.
Sir, in question number 4, we again make the states like previous one, and we again find the equivalence states. And to eliminate the options, what we did was we can see that in option B and C, both will accept the string B, whereas the option D will not accept the string BBA. Therefore, both of them are invalid string. So our final answer will be DF, will be option A. Ritesh,
she will present the last question.
Good evening, sir. My name is Ritesh Kumar Singh. As Arif and Imam present above, I am presenting question number 5. Consider the given DFA, which of the following is false? As Arif and Rahul Raj present above, come. Question 5. Statement 4 says it will accept all the statement 4 say it will be accept all the string of length at least 2, but it accept 0, which is of length 1, so 4 is false. Statement 3 says that the DFA is minimal. We will check using the algorithm discussed above. P0, Q2, Q0, Q1, P1, Q2, Q0, Q1. Since P0 is equal to P1, P1 is the final DFA, Q0 and Q1 can be merged. So minimal DFA will have 2 states, therefore statement 3 is false. So correct option is D. 3 and 4 only.
So here we comes to our end of our presentation.
Thank you, Arif.
Thank you, sir.
Arif, Rahul and Ritesh, you have taken a good topic. Really, nobody has to talk about this topic. Very good.